As Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu said, that Guru Maharaj is heading into the Rath Yatra, so it will be good to speak on this particular topic of Rath Yatra. So I thought, yes, this is a good idea. And I was doing some research on it, and there were so many interesting facets to how this Rath Yatra has now spread from Jagannath Puri to all over the world. So let's start with a little prayer. Om Agyanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vancha Kalpata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Eva Chapatitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you very much for joining in for today's class. Please accept my humble obeisances, my dear brothers and sisters, and please give me your merciful blessings that by your mercy, by your good wishes, your prayers, and your empowerment, and Guru Maharaj, and Prabhupada's, and the deity's empowerment, I will be able to speak something on this wonderful festival called the Rath Yatra, or the Festival of Chariots, as it's popularly known now all over the world. So what is this beautiful festival, Rath Yatra, all about? Many, many, many millions of years ago, King Indradumna wanted to worship the Lord, and he wanted the deity form of the Lord to be carved by Vishwakarma, the celestial architect. And he invited him to come and do this beautiful carving of the Lord so that he could worship the Lord very nicely. Vishwakarma agreed on one condition. He said, I will work in a closed room and no one should disturb me. If anyone comes and interrupts my work, I will leave it there and then, and that will be that. So King Indradumna agrees and the work begins, and he hears him knock, 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 chiseling away. But one fine day he doesn't hear anything and he gets very impatient. So he forgets his promise and he opens the door and comes inside. Immediately, Vishwakarma vanishes, but the beautiful form of Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, Maharani are there. And though they are unfinished, Indradumna Maharaj is so happy because now finally his worshipable Lord is there before him in his beautiful deity form that he decides to worship him, worship them, Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, and hold a beautiful festival of opulent worship, and fulfill his desire to worship the Lord to his heart's content. So that's how the original deities of Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra began being worshipped. And this Rath Yatra festival actually commemorates a very sweet pastime, which I will describe shortly. But in this festival, the Lord comes out of the main temple at Jagannath Puri and travels all the way to Gundicha, which is a garden temple reminiscent of Vrindavan. And he goes with his brother Baladev and with Subhadra, and it is a tremendous festival. Millions and millions and millions of people come out, and the king of Puri himself comes and very humbly sweeps the streets ahead of the cart for the Lord's cart to come down and travel that route. And there is conch shells and drums and dholes and singers and dancers, and a tremendous festival where millions and millions of people come to pull that cart and pull the Lord to Vrindavan. So it's a very joyous festival. It's a event that people come from all over the world to attend, just to see the magnificence. But for us devotees, there's a very special significance. It is pulling the Lord back into our hearts. How did that happen? After Krishna and Balaram left Vrindavan, the gopis were feeling intense separation. They longed to see the lords of their hearts. And they went to Kurukshetra at the time of solar eclipse, and they did see the Lord. But in their heart of hearts, they were not feeling the satisfaction that they felt at Vrindavan. So in their minds and hearts, they wanted Krishna back with them in Vrindavan, in the bowers, in the flower groves, in the forests of Vrindavan. So in their mind, they began building a chariot, placing Krishna and Balaram, and pulling with their own hands the cart back to Vrindavan. This was actually the pastime, and this significance of pulling the ropes of the Lord is pulling the Lord back into our hearts and bringing him back into the Vrindavan of our hearts. So that's what is the actual significance of this festival. And Srila Prabhupada wanted that people now from all over the world get the mercy of Lord Balaram, Krishna, and Subhadra Mai all over, because they do not know who is God. Many of them do not come to even visit the temple of the Lord. But Lord Jagannath is so merciful that even if we don't go and visit him in the temple, he comes out once a year to give his darshan, to give his mercy, to give his love to everyone who is benedicted by seeing this chariot festival, as it's called. So why did Srila Prabhupada want this? Because he knew that the Western mind is fascinated by color, by pomp, by pageantry, by music, by festivity. And he wanted that everyone takes part in this joyous festival and somehow come in touch with Krishna consciousness. Today we see worldwide this wonderful festival of Rath Yatra taking place, which is a complete event in itself. It's almost like Festival of India, where you have dioramas, we have book distribution, we have question answer booth, we have colorful sale of different types of Indian clothes, we have prasadam booths, we have flower garland making, and gopi dots and henna and the works. You know, everyone gets a chance to partake something of the culture and tradition of loving devotion to the Lord, which is the culture of Krishna consciousness. So why did Prabhupada want to give this to everyone? Because he knew everyone will not come to the temple. He knew everyone is not going to take part in deity worship. He knew people may not understand what is happening in the temples. But at the same time, out of his great compassion and mercy for the fallen conditioned soul, he wanted them to get that connection in some way with the Lord. It is said that anyone who pulls the ropes of the cart, or who appreciates this procession of Lord Jagannath, all his sins are completely wiped off, completely. And he's freed of all those things. Of course, they should not go on to commit sinful activities again, but this is the great mercy and benediction of just attending a festival of the chariots where Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra are taken out, and in great festivity, with great joy, with great pomp and celebration, they are taken to Vrindavan, Gundicha temple, as it's actually known as. And we want that people come to know about Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, because they're very, very merciful. This form of the Lord is so merciful that Srila Prabhupada first asked that these deities be carved and installed in San Francisco, which is where actually the first Rath Yatra also took place. And he said, we will call this temple New Jagannath Puri. And it's such a sweet pastime. Do you want to know how the first Rath Yatra happened?
Yes,
it's such a beautiful pastime. Actually, the very first Rath Yatra Srila Prabhupada himself organized was as a five-year-old boy. He was just a little five-year-old boy. But because he had seen this Rath Yatra, he wanted to organize a his own Rath Yatra. And he insisted and insisted and insisted. And finally, his father, who was very loving and very lenient and very kind with his son's desire, they went to different carpentry shops and they found out that it's too expensive, it's too prohibitive to order a cart to be made, and, you know, got ready for Rath Yatra. And Abhay, little Abhay, he began crying. I want a cart. And seeing him crying, an old Bengali lady asked, what's the problem? Why is he crying? So then Gurmohan Day, his father, explained, he wants a Rath Yatra or festival to be organized, but we cannot afford a car. She said, oh, no problem. I have a card. Come and take it. And it was an old card. It was still operable, but it needed some repairs and it needed some changes and all that to actually make it worthy of, you know, for a Rath Yatra festival to be held. But there was a card. Yay! So Gaur Mohan, they went, collected the card, and father and son together, they now decorated that card. Abhay Charan, as he was known then, even as a little boy, was so insistent on all the details. He wanted the wooden horses. He wanted the drivers. He wanted everything just as it was in the original Puri Rath Yatra. He was so particular about everything. And we can see in the right from the beginning how insistent the pure devotee of the Lord is that everything should be done nicely for the satisfaction of the Lord. No cutting corners, no making excuses, no saying, oh, it's all right. No, do your best. That we can see right from the age of 5 or even earlier, but this pastime is another illustration of Srila Prabhupada's deep devotion to the Lord. And you won't believe it, this little 5-year-old boy, he managed to entreat all the neighborhood Matajis. He entreated them, please cook something nice for Lord Jagannath's festival. Please, let's have some nice prasadam for this wonderful eight-day festival. This little child of 5 years organizes an eight-day festival every day. That rath was taken from their home down, I believe, Harrison Road to the local Radha Krishna temple and then back again. And hundreds of children participated in it, with little Abhay as the natural leader, directing everything, his sister Bhavatarani and all the other little children of the neighborhood. He was the natural leader, and he encouraged everybody to contribute, to take part, join in. And at one point, Gaur Mohan Dey's friend started saying, what is this? You're having Rath Yatra and you have not invited us? And then Gaur Mohan, they said, well, it is just, you know, a children's festival. They said, it doesn't seem like a children's festival with everyone taking part. So that's how serious it became. And you will not believe this, year after year after year, this Rath Yatra festival of Srila Prabhupada's continued. So that was the very first Rath Yatra that Srila Prabhupada organized. Now cut to 1967. Srila Prabhupada is in America, and he wants that the same mercy of the Lord should reach hundreds and thousands of souls. Why just few people? Why not the whole world be inundated with love of Krishna? See, this is the heart of a pure devotee. He simply longs for the Lord's compassion to come pouring down on everyone. So he had been looking at, you know, the American scene and seeing the trucks. Called it flatbed trucks. He said, why not organize a Rath Yatra festival where we have Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra Mai on the back of an open truck where everyone can see, and we can take them out in procession. We can distribute prasadam. We can have uproarious, tumultuous kirtan, and everyone can take part in the joy of this Rath Yatra festival. So Srila Prabhupada requested Jayananda. Jayananda Prabhu was instrumental in actually making it happen. He got the truck, he arranged for Jagannath to face the right side, Subhadra Mai to face the rear, and Baladev to face the left side, and they took their lordships out in procession. Now, these deities were carved by Shyam Sundar. There's another little story about how this happened. Would you like to hear? Yes, of course. It's so wonderful to hear all these pastimes. How did this happen? Manati Matiji was visiting a little Indian store somewhere in San Francisco, and she looked down into a little basket. There were lots of little curio items, and she picked up what she found, an intriguing little piece, you know, and she brought it to the temple, and she brought it to Prabhupada, and she showed Prabhupada. Immediately, Prabhupada offered Dandavat Pranam and said, oh, Jagannath, the Lord of the universe has come. So Malati Mataji was very intrigued. She said, who is this? What is this? And then Prabhupada explained, this is Lord Jagannath. And he asked, were there other small figurines just like this one? So Malati Mataji thought, and she said, yeah, I think there were others. And Prabhupada explained, yeah, there should be one white, one yellow, and this is black like this. So she went back the next day And she picked up the two other little figurines to go with Jagannath, which was, of course, Lord Baladev and Lady Subhadramai, and she brought them to the temple. Now that these little deities were there, Srila Prabhupada asked Shyamasundar. He said, Shyamasundar, can you carve 3 feet high deities of Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra? And Shyamasundar said, yes, I can do it. And so Shyamasundar began working on carving the beautiful deities of Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, which I worship till today in San Francisco. And that is how we had our first Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadramai in San Francisco being worshipped by the devotees. Because Srila Prabhupada knew Radha Krishna worship is very, very high standard of worship, and it is not a good idea for beginners to begin with that. But Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadramai are so merciful that just a simple program of worship, just a simple offering of cooked foodstuffs, you know, from the heart with love and devotion would be acceptable to the Lord without offenses. And so that's how Srila Prabhupada engaged Shyamasundar Prabhu in carving the deities and beginning the program of worship of Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadramai. And these were the deities that were taken out in Rath Yatra. And it was a tremendous success. It was an uproarious, joyful, tumultuous, colorful, amazing spectacle, and hundreds and thousands of people joined in that first Rath Yatra, bringing great, great happiness to Srila Prabhupada's heart, because he knew that with this success, it can be replicated now everywhere all over the world. So this is how the first Rath Yatra began, and this is how the first generation of disciples fulfill Srila Prabhupada's desire that Lord Jagannath Baladev Subhadramai Rath Yatra festival be celebrated all over the world. And this became so famous that later on, the city of San Francisco instituted a particular day called San Francisco Rath Yatra Day, Rath Yatra Parade in honor. And the police were amazed. They were saying that mostly when, you know, crowds gather, it is, you know, drunken brawls and fights and a nightmare and a mess. But this is such a beautiful festival. Everyone is so happy. The crowds are so joyful. There is no tension. There is no worry for us. We are just relaxed, even though we are here, because the difference is there's love and devotion in the air. The gopis' devotion is there in this Rath Yatra festival. And so everyone becomes very joyful, and everyone gets a taste, a tiny little part of being this instrument, small instrument in the connection of connecting the Lord back to his loving devotees, the gopis. So I wanted to bring a little bit of history there about the first Rath Yatra. And then I would like to share a little bit about the chariots themselves, just because, you know, I thought it was interesting to understand which chariot is whose. Each chariot is very different. So how do the pilgrims recognize whose chariot is whose? Because remember, these are towering chariots and they cannot immediately see the Lord. So there are various signs and symbols on each of those chariots, and I will read it out. Lord Jagannath's chariot is red and yellow color, consisting of 16 wheels, and whose deity is Sri Narsingadev. This chariot is known as Nandi Ghosh or Garuda Dhvaj or Kapila Dhvaj. Now, what is Lord Baladev's chariot? It's red and green in color, and there are 14 wheels, and the presiding deity is Sheshnag. Anandashesh. So this chariot is known as Taladvaja or Langaladvaja. I'm not able to pronounce that. Langaladvaja. Subhadra's chariot is imprinted with red and black lotus marks, and those and her chariot, the presiding deity, is a goddess, Jai Durga. And this chariot is known as Darpa Dalana or Padma Dvaja or Deva Dalana. So these are the three different chariots. And in Jagannath Puri, it's a massive festival with the chariots towering, the canopy of the chariots towering many, many meters into the sky. This was such a huge festival that the British coined the term Jagannath just to signify something huge and gigantic, because they had never seen anything like it. But this festival has been going on for millions of years in Jagannath Puri. It's nothing new. The Britishers, for them, it was new, but not for the residents of Puri or for people who are worshippers of the Lord. So I think I have covered many of the important points that I wish to mention. The mood of all the devotees is of great joy because the Lord is coming to Vrindavan and he is going to spend some time there after his Snan Yatra, which happened 2 weeks earlier. And he's going to have a relaxed time away from all the main temple, which is, you know, very grand and opulent and in the mood of the king. Now, Krishna, Balaram, and Baladev, Krishna, Balaram, and Subhadra are relaxing in their garden. They're, you know, having a sweet time without all that opulence and pageantry and pomp, and they're just relaxing and having a good time. But guess who gets angry? Goddess Lakshmi is very angry because the Lord has gone without her. So she's wondering, where is her Lord? How has he gone away without me? And where is he? Who is he with? What is going on? So she comes over there on the fifth day, Hira Panchami festival, and she demands to see the Lord. And the Lord in anger, he, you know, seeing her anger, he's hiding. So she apparently breaks a piece of the chariot and goes away. And then the Lord realizes, oh, she's very angry with me. I have to pacify her. So on the ninth day, he comes back to pacify her. But now she feigns anger, and her maidservants start quarreling with Lord Jagannath's maidservants. And they say, we are not going to let the Lord just see her like that. He has to pacify her. And so then the Lord has to pacify her with sweet words and give her a garland and say, you know, he just had to go. It just happened like that. You know, like a husband and wife, you don't have to pacify each other when the wife is angry. So this sweet pastime is played out in this pastime of Goddess Lakshmi getting very angry with Jagannath for leaving her. And then the Lord pacifying her just as a husband would pacify an angry wife with sweet words and a garland and saying that he really loves her very much and he has a lot of respect for her, but he was just forced to go by the fact that people were just pulling him along like that, and he never meant to leave her. It's such a sweet pastime between the Lord and his consort. And then finally she's appeased, and then they both are at peace. So this is known as the Hira Panchami festival, and this happens in Jagannath Puri when they enact this festival. She comes out in a palanquin and she's very angry, and her servants carry her, and then they carry her back. And all this actually happens. I have observed it because I had the good fortune of actually attending one Hira Panchami festival. So all these are such sweet pastimes of the Lord, and he enacts these pastimes to enchant us, to remind us of him, of his abode, of his love, and that we can also be part of this wonderful pastime. We can also fix our minds on the lotus feet of the Lord, engage in loving devotion, and go back to him. Because really, we are not meant to suffer here endlessly, rotting in this material world, going through, you know, the three whips of material life, adhyatmika, adhibhautika, adhidevaka, constantly attacking us. This is not how we are supposed to be. This is not how we are supposed to live. We want to live with Krishna all the time. And that comes by improving our consciousness, by being immersed in the pastimes of the Lord, by remembering the Lord all the time, by becoming his devotee, by offering homage, obeisances. Manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mameva shasi satyam te prati jane priyosimi. My dear devotee, always think of me. Become my devotee. Offer homage unto me, thus being absorbed in me, surely you will come to me. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. So this is Krishna's promise, that if we do these four things by getting absorbed in Krishna's leelas, his pastimes, his entourage, his paraphernalia, his beauty, his love, his wonderful pastimes, we will, our minds will become more and more absorbed in Krishna. We will get more and more absorbed in Krishna consciousness. We will rise above things of this material world, and we will come back to our real consciousness, which is Krishna consciousness. We are actually meant to simply be sweetly absorbed in the mood of service to Krishna. Of course, right now we are not reached that point because we are beset with so many problems and anxieties and worries and tensions and this thing. And that is why Krishna consciousness has been given, to remind us that this is not a natural state. We rise above all these things to reach the point of sweet, loving, absorbed devotion to Krishna. And one of the very sweet pastimes of being absorbed is this loving pastime of pulling Krishna back into our hearts, known as the Rath Yatra festival or the chariot festival, which has become so popular now all over the world, thanks to Srila Prabhupada. So I will end over here. I hope this was enlivening, and I will open up for discussion, for questions, for comments, for corrections, and hopefully we will have some more tuning of the nectar. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Mataji. It was so wonderful, you know, all these pastimes about the Rath Yatra, how it started, and also about the Prabhupada, you know, doing the Rath Yatra since his childhood days. Like, you know, it's wonderful pastimes, Mataji. Thank you so much for, you know, bringing back all those, you know, pastimes and letting us know. Dear devotees, anybody have any questions or clarifications or any your experiences on Rath Yatra, please share so that we can, you know, get to know about those experiences and cherish the nectar. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
So Hare Krishna.
Mataji, I would like to just share my experiences with Rath Yatra, you know, like when we were in Charlotte, actually, particularly, that's where we got the opportunity of first time, you know, involving in Rath Yatra festival, because in Charlotte, we tend to do, like, you know, every year, you know, the Thanksgiving parade, and then whenever the parade happens in downtown Charlotte, like, you know, so we tend to do the Rath Yatra as part of that parade. So, like, mm-hmm. for Thanksgiving, for even like, you know, the MLK Day, mm-hmm. Thanksgiving, and as well as the St. Patrick's Day. These are the 3 days when there are some parades happening in the downtown. So as part of those parades, you know, we tend to do Rath Yatra. So it was so wonderful with all the devotees, like, you know, dancing and pulling the Rath Yatra in the downtown of Charlotte, and, you know, with all the people around, and, you know, distributing prasadam, like, you know, the nuts, prasadam, whatever, and giving the books, a little bit of pamphlets to everybody, and, you know, sharing the mantra cards and along with the parade and dancing. It was so wonderful experiences. Like, you know, at least a couple of years we had opportunity of, like, doing 6 Rath Yatras in like 3 Rath Yatras in a year, like almost 2 years we did almost 6 Rath Yatras. So it was so wonderful, like, you know, getting the Ratha, and then, you know, decorating it and bringing the Lord onto the Ratha. It's so, I mean, as you said, like, you know, that itself is like a wonderful experience of, you know, making sure that we have that festival, you know, along with the devotees, and, you know, pulling the Ratha and having the mercy of Lord Jagannath Baladeva and Subhadra. So it's so wonderful, Mataji. So thank you so much. And, you know, really, you know, today I'm sitting here in Texas, but I was wondering, like, you know, if you were in somewhere near close to East Coast, I would have drove down to Philadelphia, and today you would have been there in that Rath Yatra, you know, in person, yeah. But unfortunately you could not do that. So right. All that in Dallas also, before that year, like, you know, we had an opportunity of doing Rath Yatra here also. So it mm-hmm. was wonderful, like, you know, with that too, you know, it's a huge gathering in downtown Dallas, like, you know, in a park where, as you said, like, we are putting all stalls of all kinds of, you know, prasadam, as well as all the items too, and mehendi, gopi dots, and like everything and anything for anybody who is coming in, like, you know, and like without any age group or anything. It's so wonderful, and everybody getting the opportunity of taking the darshan of Lord Jagannath and Baladeva Subhadramai, and then you know, involving and, you know, getting the, to get an opportunity to pull the ratha is also is like, you know, benediction. Actually, you cannot, you know, get that without the mercy. So, and making sure that a lot of those souls coming out of in Dallas downtown just to see what is it, and, you know, and getting the opportunity to do that, even though they don't know what that is, the insignificance of that, but still, you know, that's the mercy they got. So it's so wonderful, Mataji. So we are just waiting. Last year we couldn't do, and this year also, so far we haven't got an opportunity to do or attend any Rath Yatra. So hoping that soon, you know, we're gonna get to do, you know, Rath Yatra as soon as possible. Thank you,
Mataji. Maybe you will start your own Rath Yatra right there in your neighborhood. Who knows?
Exactly. That's what, Mataji. I think that's what we need to start doing right now. I think, you know.
Yes, with Siddharth and Sri Lastia and you and Srimati. Why not? We want many, many Rath Yatras all over the world. And you can have your own neighborhood Rath Yatra right there in your neighborhood. This is so beautiful, you sharing that you had almost 3 Rath Yatras every year, 6 Rath Yatras, you know, in a period of 2 years, giving so much mercy to thousands of souls. This is really what is needed, you know, flooding the world with Krishna's love in so many different ways and forms, and something for everyone. This is the most beautiful part about our festivals. There's always something for everyone. Somebody likes books, somebody likes the shadam, somebody likes the question answer, somebody likes the gopi skirt. But all the ladies, of course, and the girls will run to the gopi skirt and the gopi dress and the sari booth, and then, you know, the gopi dots. And so there's always something for everyone who wants to come and take part in this joyous festival. And this is the beauty of Rath Yatra. It attracts everyone. Everyone is attracted and everyone gets the mercy, even though they may not realize the spiritual benefit of pulling that rope or appreciating the pastime or just taking Jagannath Prasadam. They are getting the benefit. They are getting the benefit. So more the merrier. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing the joyfulness of all that happened at Charlotte. And I pray that you can replicate it now that you're here in Dallas.
Yes, Mataji. Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else, devotees, if you have any experiences, any realizations, please go ahead. We have some time. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam. Nitai Nataraj Prabhu, our intrepid dancer. Is always dancing.
Yeah, it's like outside we call each kind of family like picnic. I mean, it's one of the, because mostly people get the opportunity to serve and they get blessing. And I mean, it's nice, you know, we all get together and all kind of, so it's real nice, you know. So yeah. I enjoy theater, which this I do, you know, maybe different state, so I go when it's Rath Yatra, I usually trying to go there, you know. So it's fun, you know.
Yes, it's the most fun, most joyful, most wonderful. Yeah, most
when outdoor or outside, I mean, it's amazing, you know. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and some places which can actually organize on a very big scale and have people coming and performing, they hire expert dancers, Bharatnatyam dancers, to enact different pastimes of the Lord. They have expert musicians playing the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra in so many different ways and forms to attract more and more conditioned souls. So all kinds of things are possible, you know, the bigger, the better.
Same thing this year, they like Detroit. We was there too in Detroit. I mean, same thing, they had a big one in them. They like, even 5-6 Madanga playing drums and Kirtan. I mean, just outstanding, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was just so nice, you know. Yeah.
Yes, so
it's having Pittsburgh.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, probably. We was planning, but somehow we didn't able to make it, you know.
Yeah, just telling us, it makes the whole picture so clear, you know, of the joyfulness of these festivals and different places like Detroit and Pittsburgh, and now Guru Maharaj is in Philadelphia attending that Rath Yatra.
Philadelphia. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Namrata ji, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to our Gurudev.
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Nice to see you.
Nice How to are see you. Too. I'm doing so much better. Thanks to the merciful, loving, concerned care of my sweet God family here who have nursed me back to health. I'm doing much better. Thank you.
Good. I think now your voice looks quite better.
Yes. Previously, I was looking afraid. Guru Maharaj said, what's wrong with you? Oh, Krishna Chaitanya.
Okay. So I would like to share one experience. Firstly, 2021 was the first year I participated in the local Rath Yatra.
Mm-hmm.
So it was, I mean, really amazing. In previous years, I did know about the Rath Yatra, and we had Rath starting from one of the nearest railway station area from our place. But because there was a lot of crowd and we were, you know, kids, and so only my mother used to go. And she used to pull the rath and she used to come back. So only my mother used to attend. I or my sister could never attend that. But this year I got the chance, and by Krishna's mercy, by Jagannath's mercy, of course. So I went in. I went to the temple, took part in the entire days, you know, the kirtan, the feast preparation. And then since the temple which I went, it is the newly opened temple in the nearby area. The old temple is in the far area. So I went in the nearby temple which is newly opened. So they brought the deities from the old temple. So as soon as the deities came, we had a shower of rain and there was a nice abhishek for Jagannath ji, and it was everybody was like Hari Bol, and then they dressed up the deities, and they were like from altar to rath, they were like swinging the deities and taking them there. So I was little amazed to see that how they are in the joyous mood, and you know how they are carrying Jagannath as if like they are playing with Jagannath ji like a child. You know how you swing the child. So I was amazed by that, and then I got the chance to pull the rath for the first time, which was a wonderful experience again. And then right from Jagannath's feet, there was some bhoga offered. So after the bhoga was offered, the prasad was like, you know, they were throwing the prasad over the audience who were there. And in my hand, a banana landed.
Wow.
A prasad banana landed.
Jai.
I'm like, out of nowhere, something came in my hand.
Ecstatic.
And yes, I was like completely out of my, you know, senses, and something like merciful just came into my hand. I felt like that.
Yes. What wonderful mercy, just coming and landing in the hand like that. Special mercy of Lord Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Mai.
Yeah, so yes, it was first one, and it was a tremendous, joyous, and you know, lovely experience. So first experience. I am looking forward to many more Rath Yatras.
Yes, we can feel your joyfulness simply by your description, and the ecstasy you must have felt just getting a banana dropped into your hand like that. What great mercy is that? Wonderful. Thank you so much for sharing that wonderful, wonderful experience.
Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna devotees, dear devotees, anybody, any more realizations?
Yeah, we have so many devotees still online. We have Soumyadatri, we have Swaha, we have Shamarani, we have Madan Gopal.
Any London Rathiyatra experiences, Mataji?
So I would like to ask the London devotees. We have Ivan also, we have Madan Gopal, we have Madhavananda Prabhu. So would anybody like to share any of their Rathiyatra experiences?
Rathiyatra.
Because of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu, today we are speaking on Rathiyatra. He made a specific request. He said, Maharaj, our Guru Maharaj is heading into the Rathiyatra at Philadelphia. So Mataji, you speak about Rathiyatra. I said, all right, your wish is my command.
Thank you so much.
Because whatever the Vaishnava's desire, we have to somehow try to fulfill it. So your desire has become my command.
Oh, thank you, Mataji. Thanks. Thank you for doing that.
Thank you.
Mataji, it's almost 10:42. So maybe you can end here, Mataji. Okay.
Okay. So thank you all very much.
Thank you so much.
My delight and joy. And pleasure to speak about this beautiful pastime of Rath Yatra. And I pray that you're all well and staying safe, staying healthy, and becoming more and more invigorated to spread Lord Chaitanya movement everywhere. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
पंचकल्पितरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यश्च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः अनंत कोटि वैष्णववृंद की जय श्री प्रभुपाद की जय श्री गुरुदेव की जय
जय
माताजी की जय हरे कृष्ण
गुरु महाराज की जय हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण